Thanks for watching our AG08 quick setup series. In this video, we'll look at the physical controls for channels 1 and 2 for microphones and guitars, as well as how to use the AG08 controller software and foot switch to customize your mic and guitar effects. Channels 1 and 2 include Nuatric combo jack inputs for XLR or phone connections with the most advanced preamps in the AG series, providing 60 dB of gain. This means that popular dynamic mics like the Shure SM7B and Electro Voice RE20 that require higher gain can be used without introducing extra noise. Before connecting any cables, make sure to turn down the gain knob and faders and/or mute the channel. Only use the red plus 48 volt switch with condenser mics that require phantom power. And if your mic consistently lights up the red peak meter after setup, use the pad switch to attenuate or drop the mic signal by 26 dB. If using a headset mic on channel 1, the mic gain will instead be found in the AG controller menu under settings, where the headset mic gain can be set to low, mid, or high. If using an electric guitar or bass for channel 2, make sure to use an unbalanced or TS phone cable to connect your instrument and turn on the Hi-Z switch if your guitar pickup is passive. Once connected, you can set how much gain to apply to the electrical audio signal and then set the volume fader. Channels 1 and 2 each have on-off buttons for a compressor EQ, a voice changer on channel 1, amp simulator on channel 2, and FX on both channels, all of which can be customized in the AG controller. However, channel 1 also offers physical controls for quick changes while presenting, including pitch and formant knobs with radial indicators, and an FX knob that can change between reverb, delay, or both just by pressing the knob. The four preset buttons can also be used to save your favorite effects settings. Simply press a button to activate or deactivate a preset. While a preset is active, if a change is made with the physical knobs or in controller, the preset button will flash to indicate the change. And if the preset button is held down for 2 seconds, the flashing will stop to indicate the new settings have been saved. The AG controller can also be used to customize the preset buttons with 6 different colors. Next, we'll look at the controller's main screen, which highlights all the functions available to channels 1 and 2, while we'll cover channels 3 through 8 and the streaming output section in other videos in this series. Channels 1 and 2 allow you to individually control the compressor, equalizer, voice changer or amp simulator, panning, and FX. The preset dropdown at the top of each channel can provide a good starting point for many users and will control some or all of the parameters for each channel. Channel 1 includes 27 vocal presets with soprano, alto, or bass voices getting presets for talking or singing while using dynamic condenser or headset microphones, as well as 2 mic presets for acoustic instruments and 6 voice changer presets. Channel 2 includes the same soprano, alto, bass, and acoustic instrument presets, but swaps the voice changer presets for guitar and bass presets to take advantage of the amp simulator. Each parameter also has a green switch, so it can be toggled on and off individually. And aside from the voice changer sliders linked to the AG08's physical knobs, all other parameters can be controlled from this quick view page. Let's open the pop-up for each parameter to see the more detailed controls though. For channel 1, the left side allows you to easily switch between parameters. It also shows an input signal meter at the top and an output signal meter below the voice changer. This top screen is the compressor, which reduces the dynamic range between your loudest and softest sounds. You can move the T or threshold on the graph to set the loudness where compression begins, and R or ratio for how sharply the compression is applied after the threshold so your mic audio doesn't become distorted when you sing or talk loudly. The sliders below provide the same function with the gain and auto makeup feature, automatically setting the maximum recommended gain based on the threshold and ratio positions. Though auto makeup can be turned off if you want to set it yourself. Attack allows you to set how long in milliseconds it takes the compressor to become fully applied, while release sets the opposite length when letting off the compressor. And knee allows you to set a soft, medium, or hard curve around the threshold for a more pronounced or smoother compression point. Once set, the meter on the right will indicate how much gain reduction is being applied to channel 1. The compressor can also be turned off, allowing you to control the compressor and EQ separately. The EQ page provides you with 4 frequency bands and a high-pass filter for removing low rumbling noises. This can be turned on or off in the top right, along with the overall EQ. Shelving and parametric EQ curves are available for each band, as well as a low-pass filter for band number 4, to help remove any high ringing sounds from electrical or lighting noise. Each curve offers up to 3 parameter sliders with Q defining the breadth of affected frequencies, a slider to set the band's center frequency, and gain to boost or cut that frequency. The voice changer and voice effects are another major highlight of the AG08. The pitch and formant sliders will move when using the AG08's physical knobs. Moving the pitch knob will raise or lower your voice by 50 cents, or a quarter tone, with each detent of the knob, and can be moved by 1 octave up or down. The formant knob detents move in 3-step increments following algorithms shaped from decades of honing by Yamaha's vocal synthesizer team to emphasize the lower harmonics of your voice for a more masculine voice, or the higher harmonics for a more feminine voice. The button on the AG08 can also be used to turn the voice changer on or off, and the sliders in controller can also provide finer controls and be double-clicked to return the slider to center. The voice changer must be turned on for the voice effects section to be heard. However, it can be turned on and off independently and will also save with the Channel 1 presets when active. There are 4 voice effects: dual pitch, radio voice, tremolo, and pitch fix. While the voice changer's pitch will modulate your whole voice, dual pitch will add 1 or 2 pitches on top of your voice while speaking, giving a slightly different character. The first pitch slider moves by chromatic half steps up and down 2 octaves. If you want to move between these half steps, use the fine slider to move 50% closer to the above or below pitch. Then use the level slider to give more prominence to one or the other pitch. The pitch and fine sliders can be double tapped to return to center.
This can create some very funny voices.
The radio voice simulates old radios with the ability to set a low pass filter to reduce frequencies from 1 kHz up to 18 kHz. Set how quickly frequencies above the low-pass filter are cut off with the cutoff offset, and add more distortion to your voice with the drive slider.
Giving you a very classic and old-timey sound.
Tremolo adds an oscillating drop in volume with controls to increase or decrease the speed of the oscillations, as well as the depth that the volume drops between oscillations.
Maybe for an underwater experience.
Pitch fix is another incredibly unique function that, with a little practice, can help you auto-tune your voice. You can select the key you'd like to speak or sing in by selecting the root or tonal center of the scale, then choosing the type of chromatic, single note, major, minor, or pentatonic scale you'd like. You can also create custom scales by selecting notes on the keyboard. Then, finally use the slider to choose how much of the pitch fix effect you want to mix into your voice.
To give you a futuristic sound.
Next is the FX page, where we'll start with a reverb that provides an input and stereo output meter, along with a simple and intuitive chart to easily understand each parameter. Initial delay moves the chart to show you how long after the initial sound the reverb begins. Reverb time lets you set how long the reverb takes to dissipate, with the chart lines extending longer over time. High damp adjusts how quickly higher frequencies decay within the reverb space, and diffusion changes the size of the reverb space, with 10 providing a wider room and smoother diffusion, and 0 creating a narrower room with clearer sound. There are also high and low pass filters to help reduce unwanted reverberant frequencies at either end of the spectrum. Then, the FX send at the bottom controls the amount of reverb applied to your channel 1 audio. Along the top, we can use the drop-down boxes for default, hall, room, and stage reverb presets, as well as change the type of FX to delay. The delay screen has a similar setup with input and output meters and an intuitive display. On the right, delay time sets the time to the first and subsequent delay repetitions, up to 1.3 seconds, while feedback increases the number and strength of those repetitions. High damp again sets how present the delay's higher frequencies are within the space. And the FX send controls the amount of delay applied to the audio. Another unique feature to the delay is the mono and stereo control, and can be most easily seen with the left-right output meter. While mono repeats the same sound for both ears, stereo will bounce the delay from left to right. Finally, we can combine the delay and reverb effects with a chart for each effect at the top, along with a slider below each to set the strength of each effect separately. Below these sliders, we can access the full controls for both effects and switch between them by simply clicking on the desired chart at the top. And with it turned on, we can hear
the full effect.
The channel 1 FX can also be controlled by pressing in the FX knob to change between the delay and reverb effects, and will change the FX send value of the active effect when turned. Back on the main screen, channel 2 carries identical features except for the amp simulator, which will open now. The amp sim can be used with acoustic, electric, or bass guitars and simulates a high gain tube amp that is rich in overtones. The amp sim has 8 knobs along the top with related sliders below. High-low lets you select the amp output type, with high creating more distorted tones for a grittier sound. Gain controls the strength and drive of the incoming electrical signal at the preamp stage, while the master volume adjusts the overall volume without affecting the tone. Treble, middle, and bass sliders also help to simulate a 3-band EQ for balancing your sound. Presence will add more distortion to high frequencies and overtones without muddying down the bass frequencies, giving you a more focused sound when needed. And output determines how much of the signal you crafted goes to the output section. You can also use the channel 2 presets as a simple starting point for your sound. If you prefer using the knobs or are on an iPad, you can change their behavior in the settings menu under options so they can react to circular or linear gestures, depending on your preferences, as well as change the brightness of the LEDs on the AG08. Even more features can be found in the settings menu to help you control channels 1 and 2 along with a simple on-off trigger foot switch like the Yamaha FC5. In the settings menu under foot switch, we'll look at the first 3 since they relate to channels 1 and 2, but we'll leave the output dimmer for the output video. First is input mute, which can be used to mute any active channels. The mute button for the active channels will flash. This helps to remind you which channels will unmute when the foot switch is pressed again. You can also mute safe channels that you don't want affected by the foot switch, allowing you to always keep your channel 1 vocals active, or to simply use it to turn on and off the FX for your microphone or guitar. Guitarists can also use the tap tempo setting for controlling the delay effect timing. In the Channel 2 FX screen, the AG08 controller will average times between 4 taps of the foot switch to set the delay timing at up to 1.3 seconds. This trigger will automatically work across both channel 1 and 2 to keep them in sync. You can also set channel 1 and 2 delay timing separately in controller if you want independent delay timings. And finally, the foot switch can also be used with the voice effects on channel 1. When active, tapping the foot switch will allow you to cycle through the 4 voice effects. Once you've customized all your settings for a project, you'll likely also want to save backups for reloading later. This can also be done by opening the menu again and selecting Console Files. Console Files save all the settings from within the controller software, but you'll also want to make sure to save your SoundPad audio files separately. After you've created the settings for a new project, select New Console File and give it a name. The buttons at the top will let you rename or delete files if you make a mistake, and load each file to switch between projects, while the buttons at the top can export and backup your entire collection or import previously saved console files created by yourself or a friend. Now that you've learned everything you need to know about how to use channels 1 and 2 and FX, make sure to check out the rest of our video series to discover more ways to get connected and get control of your computer audio with the Yamaha AG08.